Adu Wiry. Number is Shea Stadium.
In the dugout, third base. As soon as I see anyone, I'll ask them to call you.
Bye.
Well, I'm building a compound, an actual compound, of rough sawn wood and plywood painted with different colored stains in almost a turret fashion. I mean, it's really funny because it turned out to look like a fortification. I'm afraid that's some indication of our concern.
The audience should have some opportunity to, touch the stars.
My feeling is, and it's really quite strong, that, the Stones presently are planning a return in small houses. I think that's wonderful. And they're, willing to do 3 and 4 concerts a night for 3 and 4 days.
Physically, for the boys to hold up under a week of concerts, it would be physically impossible. They just, day before last, finished U.S. tour that we learned just what their physical capabilities are as far as how many shows in 1 week, how many performances. There's just so much you can do physically. If you've seen Grand Funk...
Have you ever seen Grand Funk in concert?
You know that their physical presentation has a great deal to do with their show.
I looked at the Maisel's footage last night, and I looked at some television footage that was given to me by Mr. Knight. And I watched the lead singer and guitarist work the entire face of the deck. I mean, as a showman, excellent. There is showmanship there, and some of the films that I saw that I concentrated most on for placement and positioning of drum riser and movement of bassist and how he came down into his microphone and things like this, so I knew what areas to focus because we're not having the pleasure of any rehearsal or even appearance.
And Grand Funk will not be rehearsing here at all.
No, they do not rehearse.
How are your musicians going to enter this area? Are they going to come up through the ground?
No, actually they are coming down through the sky.
partner.
What's happening?
Okay.
Ready.
Now, we got two choppers to take us. We go in the big one, we'll split the crew up, go two at one time, okay? We can take two at one time. The big one will go Mark, Don, Mel, me, Axes. We'll go Andy, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, you and Howard V go in the small one, right? That takes care of all of us.
Thank you.
surround me. But I don't want no sympathy.
This portion of In Concert has been brought to you by Gillette, makers of Right Guard natural scent antiperspirant. The great wetness fighter with a light, clean scent made from natural ingredients. Right Guard natural scent.
continue following station identification. Grand Funk Railroad returns to the stage after this appearance by their special guest.
My name is Freddie King. Ain't no sunshine when she's gone. It's not warm when she's away. Ain't no sunshine when she's gone. She's always gone too long. Anytime she goes away, I wonder this time when she's gone. I wonder if she's gonna stay. Ain't no sunshine when she's gone. This house just ain't no home. Anytime she goes away. Sunshine when she's gone. Only darkness every day. Yeah. Ain't no sunshine when she's gone. This house just ain't no home. Anytime she goes away, yeah. Anytime she goes away. Anytime she goes away. Anytime she goes away. Thank you.
Thank you. Funk Railroad has taken a stand against hard drugs. We decided to do something about it that would demonstrate our feelings. In August, we approached Dr. Mitchell Rosenthal, director of Phoenix House, with the idea of contributing our total fees from two concerts in the New York area. When Don, Mel, and I returned to New York, we visited one of the five Phoenix centers, the one on 116th Street. We looked around and talked with the people in the program and sat for a while with Mitch, Frank Natale, clinical program director, and Barry Francis, director of the house we visited. Here's a brief look at what we saw and heard.
And so we decided, you know, when we got into, you know, doing a benefit, we wanted to do it for something we really believed in, you know, and do it right. So that's what we decided to do. Then we wanted to find a program that was really successful, you know, something that really works. And that's how we came to Phoenix House.
We believe that the problems that underlie drug addiction are personal emotional problems. In other words, it's not the drug that's the problem. The drug is a symptom of the problem, and it's only by our addressing ourselves to those underlying problems and helping somebody to really find out about themselves and about those things that they're afraid of, about those things that they've run from, about those things that have angered them and around which they've done destructive things to themselves. It's only in getting at those roots that people are going to end up clearing up the problem of addiction.
In most cases, this is the first time that they experience that type of relationship with a person, and with a number of people, where people are talking to you about you, asking you questions about you, letting you know and sharing with you what hurts, what doesn't hurt, what you're afraid of, what I'm afraid of. And it's for the first time in most of these people's life when they're hearing that kind of conversation.
The program here doesn't rely on any other drug. It's a totally non-drug
drug-free
program.
Completely drug-free.
No methadone, nothing.
It's hard to get an aspirin in this house.
We get a little extreme sometimes. Like, why do you have that?
And I think that dispensing drugs and allowing a guy who can't make a decision. Obviously, he can't make a decision. Obviously, he doesn't know what's right for him. You know, he needs to be told what to do at that point. He's asking for help. He's flagging. I mean, he's overdosing, shooting needles into his arm, falling all over the place, getting arrested. And then they call him in and they say, make a mature decision. Would you like to take methadone? Would you like a little heroin? Would you try DARPA? You know, or would you like drug-free? The whole thing is just so absurd.
So I don't think that the people who are trying to assess this thing politically are going to come up with the answer. I think it's going to come out of the youth culture itself and out of an enlightenment in that youth culture that says, hey, take a look at this. We've got to stop it. We've really got to stop the whole internal pollution that's been going on before it just chokes us all.
That's the message that comes when guys like yourself do a concert. You know, or make a statement, do something like what you're doing with Phoenix House now, because I agree with Mitch. I think that's where the turnaround is going to come, and it's going to have to come from youth itself.
People get values that they have about drugs from their first of all from their family, and later from their friends, and then from those other people out there who they look up to, and that's really why your role is so critical, because young people are looking for people who they can believe in, who seem to be having fun and making it, and that you can be having fun and making it and be out of hard drugs is, you know, really very important.
You know, when they take a look at the situation that this country is in, and it's not very hard, you know, to get out of it. I mean, all you gotta do is look around and you see that, you know, there's troubles everywhere, and so they want to get away from it, but like you say, getting away from it isn't going to solve the problem. You know, it's going to take a strong physical body and mental body, you know, a clean body, to overcome the dirt that is here now.
of the United States.
And bars, they surround me, but I don't want no sympathy.
Thank you.
once I had a little girl. Sometimes I think about her, but you know she's not really there. Memories come, I just can't live without her. I'm trying all the time.
Right now we'd like to do a couple songs off our new album for you. And we're gonna keep it shining on in here. like to ask some friends of ours from Wet Willie to come out and join us. Come on, where are you? Here they go. And we want everybody to join us as we cook up some steam and get on board for the locomotion. All right. Everybody's doing a brand new dance now.
Come on, baby,
yeah.
Feel the locomotion.
I know you get to like it if you give it a chance now.
Come on, baby,
feel
the locomotion.
Three.
Shock me if my head all of a sudden said, well, I'm going to be a dock worker in Holland. I'd probably just up and do it.
Mark's like an Indian. He digs outdoors.
Mark's the guy I grew up with.
Mark's the guy you stole from that band.
Yeah. I got you in our group.
Yeah, I remember that.
Last week, a buddy of mine caught a 0.6-inch pike out of here, right up here by the middle pond.
I ain't had much time for fishing this year.
You ready to ride, brother?
To your town, we'll help you party down. We're an American man.
takes two shots if you don't catch him. He does it sly.
No. Dark, mysterious.
Uh-oh.
Bass player. Check. He reverberates with his speakers.
Feels it. Feels what he's playing.
Yeah, it's like sex. You gotta feel it.
No, the black varmint.
Craig is a depressive humorist.
Somebody tell me, Mark, who am I?
You crazy?
You can trust me. You got insurance, you can trust me with it. I wouldn't be a speed freak with it. I wouldn't. It's got it. It's the only thing I've got. I don't know. You can't apply yet. Oh, thanks. Cut. Like seatbelts in the door.
Cut. Hey, come on.
Thank you.
ass kicker. And now, we're gonna take a step back, and we're gonna dedicate this song to everybody. Everybody in this little place doing their thing. Time doing the best I can. Balls and bars, they smile on me. But I don't want no sympathy. make you feel real good. Not just to watch you sing.